goal of treatment is always remission. All patients need to be on an antimalarial drug. They are the mainstay of treatment. And these are hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine. They decrease the chance of flares by 50%. They help patients live longer. They protect their brain and their kidney from lupus. They help the skin and the joints. And unless somebody has difficulty tolerating them, we put everybody on them. The risk of using them is a risk of retinopathy. Sometimes they can deposit in the back of the eye. And for this, patients need regular screening. Now, in the olden days, NSAIDs like ibuprofen and naproxen were used for some manifestations of lupus like pericarditis or swollen joints. Nowadays, we generally tend to avoid them because they are associated with a higher cardiovascular risk. Patients with lupus have a baseline elevated cardiovascular risk, so we try to avoid adding to that risk. Corticosteroids, we also try to avoid in the long run. Lupus patients are very sensitive to steroid side effects. And there's data that the incidence of these adverse effects with glucocorticoids is more common than in other autoimmune diseases for unknown reasons. So patients with lupus will gain weight, they can have high blood pressure, high cholesterol, glaucoma, cataracts, gastritis or bleeding from the bowels, osteonecrosis, which is like a heart attack of the bone where the blood vessels constrict and don't get blood to the bone anymore. There's an entire range of metabolic complications that occur with it. So we try to avoid them unless absolutely necessary. Cardiovascular risk is high in lupus. It's a common misconception that the main problem in the long run is lupus itself. It's not. We are pretty good at treating lupus flares. We're pretty good at treating infections that may span from the disease itself or from the treatment. But after 10 or 20 years, the main problem that patients face is a cardiovascular risk that's highly elevated. So addressing the cardiovascular risk factors is an extremely important thing. The cardiovascular risk is equivalent to someone who has diabetes. So exercising, avoiding weight gain, eating healthy, making sure your blood pressure is under control, making sure your cholesterol is under control. These are very important things that patients need to work on. Thank you.